Vulnerability assessment and advanced threat protection are two awesome capabilities that come in Azure SQL. But did you know that with Azure Defender for SQL, you can actually get this anywhere your SQL is running? Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by David. David, why don't you start by telling us a little bit about yourself and what you do?
Hi, Anna. Hi, everyone. Thank you. Yes, sure. My name is David Trigano. I'm Program Manager at Microsoft, working on the Azure Security Center product group. And my team and I focus on securing SQL Server anywhere.
Awesome. Thanks, David. And securing SQL Server anywhere, that's kind of related to what we wanted to talk about today, and that is Azure Defender for SQL. Now, you know, David, for those of us that are new to this, I'm pretty new to this myself. Can you tell us what is Azure Defender for SQL?
Sure. Good question, actually. So Azure Defender for SQL is a security bundle, part of the Azure Defender family. It provides SQL Server, protects SQL Server with two main capabilities. So the first one is called Advanced Threat Protection. It's a feature that provides a set of advanced security capabilities to detect anomalous activities indicating unusual and potential harmful attempts to access or exploit SQL Servers. The second capability, or the second feature, is SQL Vulnerability Assessment. It's a feature that helps customers to ensure their SQL Servers are well configured and allow them to improve their SQL security posture.
Thanks, David. That's really cool. You know, vulnerability assessment and advanced threat protection are two really awesome security capabilities. Now, when we talk about Azure Defender for SQL, you know, where is this supported? What versions? What environments?
So recently, we announced that Azure Defender for SQL supports any type of SQL, any flavor of SQL anywhere. So it means that we can support managed SQL that runs on Azure. We can even support SQL Server that run outside of Azure. On any cloud provider powered by Azure Arc, on-premise, or as I said, on any other cloud provider.
Wow, that's pretty cool. So when you say anywhere, you mean anywhere. So now, you know, if I wanted to go and set this up or deploy and configure this, you know, how easy is it to do that?
Well, this is super easy. I'm going to show you within a minute. It's a simple click. You can use Azure Security Center to deploy Azure Defender for SQL, and our customers can enable it on their subscriptions on Azure, allowing them to protect any existing SQL assets and any new SQL that will be created in the future. Let me show you how it works. So here I am on my Azure portal. I'd opened Azure Security Center, clicked on pricing and settings, and selected my subscription. You can see that currently on this subscription, Azure Defender is not enabled. But I can, with one simple click, enable it. Now, Azure Defender protects my entire state in both hybrid and multi-cloud environments. In addition, Azure Security Center provides a dashboard centralizing Azure Defender coverage and a view to track the alerts raised on the resources, both inside and outside Azure. Now, let's focus into a specific Azure Arc-enabled server, SQL Server that is hosted outside of Azure. With Azure Arc, Azure Defender for SQL provides similar protection experience across SQL servers, both inside and outside of Azure. Let's look at the security page to see the security recommendations and alerts that are available for both SQL Server and the underlying Windows operating system. Let's drill down into the findings of high severity SQL vulnerability assessment recommendation. So here, Azure Defender for SQL continuously runs a set of security checks against protected SQL servers. It reports a list of findings upon discovery of security misconfigurations, excessive permissions, or unprotected sensitive data. Here you can see two typical findings that indicate this SQL server is vulnerable for attacks like the Vulgar campaign. For example, you see the XP command shell is currently enabled and should be disabled, and the default login SA is not disabled. Let's have a look into the second finding. SQL vulnerability assessment provides you relevant information about the vulnerability that was found, including the reason, remediation steps, impact, and even a query to fix it. It also provides you a list of security benchmarks that are related to this finding. Now, if we go back on the security page for the SQL Server, you can see that Azure Defender has also detected a brute force attempt on this Azure Arc-enabled SQL Server machine. It is apparent that the brute force attacks is related to the fact that the well-known SQL SA login has not been disabled. Clicking on the alerts shows more details on the resource that was attacked. You can see the resource is Azure Arc-enabled SQL Server, and it's also tagged as being for a production environment. In addition, you can see more information about the suspicious activity that was detected. You see that the attacker has made 100 attempts to exploit the SA login. Let's see now what are the actions that are recommended by Azure Defender to mitigate this threat. The Azure Defender recommendation suggests mitigating the threat by blocking the attacking IP address of the client from where the brute force attack came. It also suggests disabling the SA login. Lastly, you see that Azure Defender alerts are integrated with Azure Sentinel, which means the SecOp team can also see the security incident using the central dashboard. The SecOp team can choose to further investigate the SQL brute force incident by using Azure Sentinel's advanced investigation tool. The SecOp team can explore the host entity in Azure Sentinel's investigation graph and can notice that there are additional security incidents on the SQL Server that indicates a popular attack has occurred. In that case, it seems like the vulgar campaign. By going through the timeline, you can see the chronology of the malicious activity that indicates the attacker has gained initial access through the SQL brute force attack, then managed to leverage SQL Server XP command shell ability to run a malicious script on the Windows machine that launched a crypto miner.
Wow, David, that's a lot of things that you just showed us. So, you know, if I kind of think about what you showed us, first, you showed us how I can get Azure Defender for SQL on SQL Server that was not running in Azure. So that's what I wanted to make clear, is that that was an Azure Arc enabled SQL Server. So it could have been running on-prem or somewhere else. Is that right?
Yes, exactly. So we now can secure and protect SQL anywhere. It means it can be a SQL on Azure. It can be a SQL outside of Azure using Azure Arc.
That's awesome. And then what I also found really cool is that, you know, we were able to see all of those resources, whether they were living outside of Azure or inside of Azure, kind of in one place, and all those recommendations. So that's really cool. And then on top of that, it integrates into this Azure Sentinel, which again, I'm assuming is going to be across all of my, you know, whether my SQLs are on-prem or in Azure.
Absolutely. And in addition to this, because Azure Defender for SQL is part of an Azure Defender ecosystem, part of a family of products, we can also integrate it with alerts that are coming from the underlying Windows operating system.
Awesome. Cool. Well, David, this has been so interesting. You know, if people want to learn more about Azure Defender for SQL, where do you recommend that they start?
That's a good question, actually. So my first advice for you guys is to start by looking into Azure Defender for SQL in our documentation, and of course, check into Azure Security Center.
Awesome, thanks, David. We'll also put a link in the description for you to get pointed right to the correct documentation. David, I wanna thank you so much for joining us today on the show. I wanna thank our viewers for joining us. If you found this interesting, leave us a comment, leave us a like, and subscribe to our channel. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.